Very good morning. Welcome to Financial Freedom Show. I'm C.S. Sudhir. Mr. Arjun has posted a question on the Financial Freedom app. He says, you always talk about comparing health insurance plans offered by different companies. Why should we really compare? Can't we just choose health insurance plans based on the price premium they offer? Why should we look at other things? Let me tell you, price is one factor here. Price is not the only factor to compare. There are actually about 8 things which you need to compare at least. Of course, if you are an expert, you can probably look at various other things, but otherwise, at least 8 parameters you need to compare, which includes pricing, while you buy a health insurance plan. The number one factor you need to consider is premium. Of course, premium differs from companies to company. They actually design these packages based on the benefits they offer. So for example, company A may say, I'm giving you 5 lakh coverage at just 10,000 rupees. Company B may say, hey, for 5 lakh, I'm charging you 20,000. There is a difference. The exclusions will differ, the features will differ, benefits will differ. Hence, you can't just simply take based on the pricing or the premium. You should also look at sum assured. What is sum assured? So now what happens when I'm looking at the coverage? The health insurance company may give you coverage like 5 lakh, 10 lakh, on all that, right? So you need to decide who is giving you maximum coverage, whatever is required to you. This is something which I've already advised you. I have suggested that you should not just go for one basic health insurance policy. Instead, you can probably consider having about 5 or 10 lakh basic health insurance and about 25 to 50 lakh rupee super top-up plan. That's the ideal way of looking at it. And the next thing is exclusions. What is exclusions? What all is not covered under this plan? You know, in case if you fall sick, the hospital or the health insurance company should not say, sir, this is not covered under your health insurance plan. Then what do you need to do? You'll have to pay from your pocket, right? I don't want that to happen. And then pre-existing diseases. When I say pre-existing diseases, I mean, assume that you have already got, you know, diabetes or you have some other health problem. So when you buy a health insurance plan and after a month or two, if you fall sick, health insurance company will say, sir, that's not covered. So you have to check with them since, you know, from when it is covered. Is it after 2 years of taking the policy, 3 years of taking the policy? So you should always negotiate there. And then there is something called pre-hospitalization and post-hospitalization expenses, which means as long as I'm there in the hospital, I know I'm covered. But what about the expenses I have to incur before I get admitted for a surgery? Or what about those expenses which I will have to incur once I get discharged from the hospital? Who's going to cover those expenses? Whether it is covered in the health insurance policy? Yes, it is covered in most of the companies, but not in all the policies. So you'll have to compare there. Then you'll have to check the max coverage age, which means will they give you coverage until you turn 80, 85? These days, you have health insurance plans available till the age of 85, 90. So nothing to worry about it. But then some companies will say, hey, I can give you maximum till 60 or 65. Post that you can't continue with this, you'll have to have a different plan, senior citizen plan. That may not help. So you should ask them, can I graduate this plan to a senior citizen plan when I, you know, enter the age of 60 or 65 or 71? And then you'll have to also check whether they have this premium hike every year and what percentage hike will happen. Which means, see, think about it. In term insurance, what happens, whatever the premium you agree on will remain the same throughout the policy term. But in health insurance, every year it increases. But that's predefined, wherein as per the age it will increase. Apart from that, based on the inflation, they also increase the premium. What percentage they will increase? You have to check all that and you have to have the premium table with you so that, you know, you'll have clarity how much you may have to pay after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. Consider all these things. It's not so easy. This is why we have designed a detailed course on health insurance in Financial Freedom App. In case if you have not watched, please watch it. It's a detailed A to Z course. Not just that, I mean, we have about 55 courses on personal finance, career, business and farming on Financial Freedom App. Please watch all those courses. If you have any doubts on these courses, please post your question on the Financial Freedom App. I will answer your question in my next episode. Thanks for watching. Be wise, get rich.